All right, this is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have a very exciting episode for you. We're using a paintbrush, but we're not painting. What we're doing here is I have my fajoa tree, and these are the fajoa flowers, and you may have seen that I really love to eat the fajoa petals, and these petals taste just like the fruit. They're really good, really sweet, but that being said, I'd rather have fruit than petals. So right now we could harvest all the petals, you know, and not compromise, you know, damaging, you know, one of the fruits that form. Because what happens is at the base of the flowers, these form and turn into the fruit if the fruit gets pollinated. So you can see some of these flowers already drying out, and some of these, you know, may just drop off, but some may form into fruit. And the reason it forms into fruit or not is if it is pollinated. So, you know, most people will hand pollinate fruit trees and actually other crops. You could hand pollinate tomatoes and other things, and if you really want to get anal, you could hand pollinate everything and ensure that everything is gonna make fruit. But for the most part, nature and wind, birds and the bees and insects do the pollination, so you don't have to. But I've noticed that on the specifically on the fajoa tree, you know, it'll flower like mad, like crazy, and I'll get maybe a dozen fruits if I don't hand pollinate. If I hand pollinate, that, you know, number will go up dramatically. So that's why we're out today with a paintbrush, and we're just gonna spread the pollen. So Adam's gonna be the pollinator. It's like the Terminator in reverse. So you basically just come up to the petals, and you can see this is all the pollen. You can see me brushing the pollen. Literally a little bit gets on the tip of the brush. You go to the next one, and literally all you do is you just brush each one. I mean, it couldn't be any simpler. And you can see kind of the pollen. I'm stirring up the pollen, and as the pollen comes off, it's getting kind of transferred, and it'll hit this one. And basically, you just go around flower to flower and spread pollen between every little one as much as you can. And just, I mean, it just takes time to spread the pollen. Some of the flowers already dried up, so we've missed it. But that's how easy it is to just pollinate your trees. And you could pollinate other things. And certain things need to be pollinated. So, for example, the vanilla orchid plant. If it's grown outside where it's originated, where it originally grew, there's a certain bug that has like a long tail, or I don't know, some appendage that actually goes in the long flower of the vanilla orchid to pollinate it and to spread the pollen between the orchids. And if you don't have that, you know, certain insect, and I don't know what it is on the vanilla orchid, that plant or the vanilla orchid won't form a vanilla bean. So if the vanilla orchid or the vanilla plant's not grown in a place where it originally originated, they don't have that insect. So places like Hawaii and other places that grow vanilla orchids, for example, you must hand pollinate or you will not get any fruits of your labor. So we're gonna hand pollinate to increase our, you know, fruiting capability. It's not required, but some fruits it may be. So, you know, this tree here is from South America originally, and we may not have the same bugs and insects that would naturally pollinate this, you know, because we're in North America now, not South America. So that's why we need to do this. But trees in their native habitat have grown up with the insects and the birds and the bees around there, and so they'll be pollinated fine. If you're bringing things in from other places, you know, you may need to hand pollinate. And hand pollination could probably only ever help. I don't see how it could necessarily hurt unless you're doing it wrong and damaging some of the plants when you're pollinating. So I encourage everybody to hand pollinate, and we're gonna get back to hand pollinating here. So hopefully I'll have lots of fajoas to show you guys in the wintertime. So this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time, and you know, keep a couple clean spare paintbrushes around to pollinate when you need them.